must you leave me so soon?
You'll have to be at work in an hour.
I know, but we just met.
Well, remember, I'll see you again tonight.
I'll miss you.
I'll miss you too. Sweet dreams.
Morning.
Morning.
How was the party?
Hmm?
The party, how was it?
Kind of boring.
Oh.
How was the poetry reading?
Kind of interesting. Something wrong?
No, that's great. Is this yours?
Mm-hmm.
It's good.
Thank you. Let's have lunch today.
Lunch? Today?
Yeah, the Algonquin, 1 o'clock.
The Algonquin, 1 o'clock. Okay.
No, no, stop! Pick it up. Make it faster. With me. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Is here, Mr. White.
Okay. Take a break and stick around. You might learn something from a real star. Anne, honey, ready to try your new number?
Why not? And of course, Prince Charming is the theme, the he for me. Although I realize.
What's the problem, honey?
I just don't feel it.
You're taking it too fast, Miss Pennington.
Quiet.
Too fast? You want it slower?
Yes, it's meant to be a slower.
Well, how can I shimmy to it if it's slower?
Well, you're not meant to shimmy to it.
Not meant to shimmy to it? Are you out of your mind? This is Anne Pennington, the queen of shimmy.
I know that.
Quiet. Well, darling.
No, it just won't do. I'm sorry, Mr. Gershwin.
Well, don't you worry about it. We'll just have to find you a better number, won't we, George?
Thank you so much.
No, thank you, honey.
Give that song to one of the girls. Now, all you have to do is to write our star a new number.
Mr. White, about
Schwartz,
these bills...
you're fired.
Can I have that in writing?
It's a crying shame. That was a great song.
Thanks. But no song's great until someone sings it. How was it with Gloria last night?
Gloria? She's wonderful.
What about your other girl?
Kate?
Yeah.
She's wonderful, too.
So now you got two girls, huh?
She's wonderful, too. What am I gonna do? 'Cause all I can think about each lovely dame is she's wonderful.
different. I mean, Gloria's so beautiful. And Kate's so smart.
Pardon me, Mr. Jones. I just hate to disturb you, but your lunch date's arrived.
It's not even noon.
And her damn limo's blocking half the damn street!
She's simply wonderful.
Bring it back.
Hey! Gloria!
Oh, darling!
What are you doing here?
I just couldn't wait. Tonight seems so far away.
But I'm supposed to be at work right now.
Oh, no, sweetie. It's time for lunch.
Right. I'm supposed to be at lunch. Lunch.
Oh, isn't this perfectly divine?
Yeah. It's just that I really don't have much time.
Oh, poo. Now, where should we have lunch?
Well, I thought...
A picnic! Oh, how gorgeous. How clever you are.
I'm sorry. Ow, my feet, ow.
Horton, drive us to Chez Maurice.
Yes, madam. Sorry. Right away.
Newport, doesn't that sound simply gorgeous?
But Gloria, I have to work.
And I have shopping to do. But we can be with each other all the rest of the time. Oh, indeed. Since last night, all I've been able to think about is you. Have you been thinking about me too, darling? Isn't this perfect? Don't say you have to get back to that horrid old theater.
No. The truth of it is, I have to run an errand for Mr. White. Maybe you could drop me off.
All right.
Okay.
Remember tonight, darling.
Okay.
The penthouse, 10 o'clock.
Okay.
Don't be late, darling. Some car.
Yeah, it's Mr. White. Sometimes he, actually, I was just running some errands.
Well, I hope you worked up an appetite. You're about to meet the vicious circle. Thanks. Hello, everyone. I'd like to introduce a friend of mine. Alexander Wolcott.
Franklin Adams, Dorothy Parker, Harold Ross, Edna Ferber, Beatrice Kaufman, Robert Benchley, George Kaufman, Indiana Jones.
Hello. Kate, what news on Broadway?
Oh, not a lot.
Then why do you look so indecently ravishing? Don't say you're in love.
Alec, you're old enough to know better. Older.
Who are these people?
Oh, they're critics mainly. Edna writes novels, Dottie reviews and writes poetry.
Be brave, my darling. I promise I'll cook you a wonderful dinner tonight.
And we haven't got a penny.
Tonight, no.
Oh, Mr. Jones, tell me, have you forgiven your parents yet?
What for?
For naming you after the dullest state in the Union.
Actually, I name myself after my dog.
Kate tells me you're with George White's Scandals, Mr. Jones.
Only as assistant stage manager.
I hope it's a better show than his last one.
You didn't like it?
Well, I saw it under bad circumstances. The curtain was up.
The last act was better than the first. Of course, it had to be. Nobody could keep down that average.
It was a bad play saved only by a bad performance.
In heaven's name, let's hurry or we'll miss the intermission.
You have to see a burlesque show, Ziegfeld, your man.
Well, actually, it's not a burlesque show. It's fun. It has great music.
And plenty of half-naked girls.
Well, sure, but so does The Follies. I mean, what makes that show better?
Good taste, Mr. Jones. Ziegfeld glorifies the American girl. White, merely undresses.
It sounds like you've written your notices already, before the show's even open.
It has been known. I hope you won't think the worst of us.
From his expression, he couldn't.
Enough of this trivia. My children, I have a treat for you. Oh. A treat, did I say? Nay, a wonder.
A joy.
This is not a novel to be tossed aside lightly.
It should be thrown with great force.
Ah, Dottie, do not jest. Observe, rather.
And marvel.
Handle it reverently and with love. But what could possibly be more rare than a Woolcott first edition?
Woolcott second edition?
Welcome to the round table, Indiana Jones.
Next.
40! 21! 33!
Like you told me. So, what's going on out there?
White's auditioning new chorus girls.
Can I get you a cup of coffee?
Coffee? What for?
I just thought.
One drink never hurt anybody.
Well, yes, sir, but. Peggy? I couldn't meet you. It was completely my fault. I just...
Gosh,
I missed you.
Missed you, too. What are you doing here?
I work here, backstage.
Oh, gosh, you're lucky. I just blew my audition. Did you see me? I was...
Stay here.
Indy?
Just don't move.
Mr. White, could I have your attention?
Schwartz!
I'm fired, yes. Yes, I know. But these figures are getting serious.
You have 30 seconds.
Girl, Peggy Peabody.
She wasn't too good.
Yeah, I know, but I've heard her. I mean, she can really sing.
Well, we need a dancer.
Yeah, I know, but she's really great, George. I mean, she's got real talent. I know, she'd be terrific in the show.
Mr. White, let go? Peggy Peabody?
Loved you.
They did?
You start tomorrow. Is that okay?
Oh, Indy. What time do you get off?
Well, 6 o'clock.
I'll meet you at the stage door. I know the most wonderful little diner. We'll celebrate.
But Peggy,
I'm so happy. I don't think I've ever been so happy in my whole life.
Indy? Indy? Telephone.
Hello? Joe.
Oh, Kate. Hi. Oh, yeah, it's crazy here, too.
See you in an hour at the corner of 47th Street and Broadway.
No,
Peggy. Don't argue. I owe you, and I'm buying dinner.